माननीय सदस्य
चीफ ऑफ ट्रेजेडी,
माननीय सदस्य आप वर्तमान बजट पे बोले 2016 के बाद तो 2019
सर मैं
जवाहरलाल नेहरू का बात लोग बोलेगा
सर,
जवाहरलाल नेहरू की बात लोग बोलेगा।
कोई साठ साल पहले जवाहरलाल नेहरू का बात करेगा, दूसरे नेताओं का बात करेगा, तब आप कुछ नहीं बोलेंगे।
सब बोलते
मैं 5 साल पहले का डिमोनिटाइजेशन का बात करूंगा तो आप कहेंगे भाई वर्तमान में छुपे बोलिए।
बजट
सर ये पक्षपात नहीं चलेगा सर।
बजट पे
मैं बजट पे ही बोल रहा हूँ। जब जब बिप्लब देव बोल रहा था तब 100 साल पुराना बात कर रहा था, 50 साल पुराने इमरजेंसी का बात कर रहा था, तब आप चुप थे। और अब मैं डिमोनिटाइजेशन का बात कर रहा हूँ, आपको चुप रहे। वाह सर वाह,
बोलिए अपनी बात पे।
डी फॉर ट्रेजेडी, जो राम को लाए हैं हम उनको लाएंगे बैकफायर्ड सर। ओके, स्लोगन ऑफ जो राम को लाए हैं हम उनको लाएंगे बैकफायर्ड। आई वुड रादर से प्रभु राम आए तो न्याय आया, कुछ वक्त जरूर लगा लेकिन इंसाफ आया। बीजेपी नॉट ओनली फेस्ड अ ह्यूमिलिएटिंग डिफीट from the Ayodhya seat, but it also lost Badrinath in the last by-election. Rather than investing in the future of this country, it is unfortunate that the union government is investing for Modi ji's political survival at the expense of nation's well-being. Truth is, the honorable prime minister is on borrowed time. You all are on borrowed time, mark my words. And I would like to end by saying, थोड़ा सबर रखिए और कुर्सी का पीटी बांध लीजिए, मौसम बिगड़ने वाला है। सर एक बार सुन लीजिए।
एक मिनट प्लीज, माननीय सदस्य आप भी बैठ जाए। एक मिनट, माननीय सदस्यगण, हमें ये प्रयास करना चाहिए कि जो इस सदन का सदस्य नहीं हो उसके बारे में टिप्पणी नहीं करें, सभी लोग इसकी पालन करने का प्रयास करें।
सर मैं एक
प्लीज बोल दिया ना सबको
बोल सर।
नो हम लोग तो बोलते हैं, बीजेपी लोग जब करते हैं आप लोग कुछ नहीं बोलते। क्यों नहीं?
एक मिनट
क्यों नहीं?
आप उनको नहीं बोलने देना चाहते, आप उनको डिस्टरबेंस कर रहे हैं। प्लीज अभिषेक जी, एक मिनट अभिषेक जी, एक मिनट। मैंने सभी माननीय सदस्यों को, आप डायरेक्शन देंगे क्या मुझे? नो प्लीज बैठिए, प्लीज माननीय ऐसे मत कीजिए, प्लीज ऐसे माननीय सदस्य मेज मत थपाइए। जब आपको बोल दिया बैठना है तो बैठना है। अभिषेक जी
मैं एक चीज से स्पष्ट करता हूँ, ऑनरेबल चेयरमैन सर ने बोला जो इस सदन के सदस्य नहीं है कोई भी सदस्य उनके खिलाफ कोई टिप्पणी नहीं करेगा। सर मैं आपसे इतना पूछना चाहता हूँ, पश्चिम बंगाल के चीफ मिनिस्टर ममता बनर्जी सदन के सदस्य है नहीं है तो उन्होंने क्यों टिप्पणी किया? सर आप अपना पद का मान रखिए सर, उनको उठ के बोलिए माफी मांगेगा। देन आई विल कंटिन्यू माय स्पीच। नो सर, यू हैव टू इंटरवीन सर, यू आर द स्पीकर ऑफ दिस हाउस। नो सर,
एक मिनट प्लीज,
मैं हाथ जोड़ के,
ए बड़े जंतु,
हमी
हाथ जंतु,
हमी हाथ
बड़े,
प्लीज प्लीज प्लीज
आग्रह करता हूँ, विनम्र रूप से मैं आग्रह करता हूँ सर, उनको बोलिए आप स्पीकर के नाते, अध्यक्ष के नाते, इस सदन का गरीबा के लिए आप उनको बोलिए उठ के वो माफी मांगेगा।
मैं प्लीज प्लीज आपको कंटिन्यू करना है तो करिए, उनका नाम सदन के रिकॉर्ड से निकाल दिया है, नहीं करना है तो आप डायरेक्शन मत दिए कि उनको माफी मांगाई। आप मुझे डायरेक्शन नहीं दे सकते, मैंने उनका नाम निकाल दिया, ऐसे कई बार हुआ है सदन में, पहले निकाल दिया।
सर D for deprive. You spent 2,000 crore on revamping Central Vista. You did this to improve the homes of the rich, influential and powerful. What have you done for the homeless in the cities, towns and villages? Why have you deprived the homeless across India and Bengal. You are not only visionless and shameless. You are not.
एक मिनट,
सर, he is not even listening to you.
अब क्यों डिस्टर्ब मैं बाद में आपकी बात सुन लूँगा.
सर, he is not
आपकी बात सुन लूँगा.
सर, सो
नहीं नहीं सब निकाल देंगे प्लीज. सर, निकाल देंगे.
उसको भी
सर, ये तो आपका बात भी नहीं सुन रहे. डिप्राइविंग रूरल पुअर. मोदी जी की तीसरी बार गरीबों के ऊपर लगातार अत्याचार. सर, ओवर द पास्ट डिकेड द बीजेपी लेड सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट हैज मेड इट्स बांग्ला विरोधी स्टैंड्स अबंडेंटली क्लियर बाय डेलिबरेटली डिप्राइविंग पीपल एंड अब्यूजिंग पावर टू सप्रेस बंगाल्स वॉइस. दे हैव मेड एन एरे ऑफ हॉलो प्रोमिसेस, disrespected Bengal's culture and hatched continuous conspiracies to tarnish the state's image. Failing to fight us politically, you declared an all-out war on our rural poor, depriving them of roti, kapda and makan. Sir, Honorable Finance Minister gave a statement today in Rajya Sabha saying that Bengal has failed to implement the scheme that Central has aided in the last 10 years. Sir, I challenge the Honorable Finance Minister if she can release the white paper of how many dime, penny or rupees the central government has given to Bengal after its embarrassing defeat in the West Bengal legislative elections in 2021. Sir, in the last 3 years, let me put this on record. And sir, main kuch bolunga wo sahi ho sakta hai. आप उसके टिप्पणी करेंगे, वो सही हो सकता है, गलत हो सकता है. सर, कागज तो झूठ नहीं कहता है. मैं बस इतना कह रहा हूं कि 2021 में आपने बंगाल में हारने के बाद आपने मनरेगा के लिए बंगाल में कितना पैसा दिया और आवास योजना में 2021-22, 22-23, 23-24 फाइनेंशियल वर्ष में आपने अगर साबित कर दिया व्हाइट पेपर रिलीज करके कि 10 पैसा दिया है, 10 पैसा. सर, देखिए, मैं व्हाइट पेपर मांग रहा हूं, ये चिल्ला रहे. अरे भैया, व्हाइट पेपर दे दो, कहानी खत्म. सर, जिसके पास कागज नहीं होगा, सर, व्हाइट पेपर मांग रहे हैं, सर, व्हाइट पेपर मांग रहे, चिल्ला रहे. इनके पास कागज नहीं है और पूरा देश से कागज मांग रहे हैं सीए का नाम पे. ये बीजेपी है. सर, मनरेगा फंड्स टू द ट्यून ऑफ 6,913 करोड़ have been forcefully withheld, denying wages to more than 59 lakh workers over the past 3 years. Sir, 11,36,000 eligible families have been deprived of a roof over their heads as 8,140 crore rupees under PM Awas Yojana have been deliberately halted. Sir, the government withheld the release of over 800 crore under the National Health Mission due to non-compliance and certain color branding guidelines for health and wellness centers, despite other conditions being duly met. Sir, despite 334 central and NLM teams visiting West Bengal in the last 3 years and ATRs being submitted on time by concerned departments of the state government against every observation that was made by the center, still no funds have been released. Official interactions with the Honorable Prime Minister and the other BJP ministers of the concerned department were met with dismissive attitude and constant rejection. Our leaders fighting for the people of Bengal were even detained in Delhi by Delhi police. Even women MPs were manhandled and dragged by their hair. And this BJP talks about Nadi Shakti. So the finance minister yesterday in a speech proposed flood control initiatives for states like Bihar, Assam, Himachal Pradesh, Sikkim, and Uttarakhand, sir. Unsurprisingly, Bengal was once again left out in spite of northern part of Bengal being one of the most worst flood-affected areas. Despite 6 out of 8 MPs from PCs that falls under the northern part of Bengal being from BJP, this is the kind of discrimination meted out to our state. I hope people of Jalpaiguri and Alipurduar are watching this and listening to what I'm saying. The finance minister, as long as we stand as people's representative, the rights of Bengal's people cannot be taken away. The state government of West Bengal has already cleared the pending wages of 59 lakh Manrega workers from its own treasury. It has also been decided that the first installment of funds for the construction of houses shall be released by 31st December 2024, which is by end of this year. In 2022 and 2023, under the Pothoshri scheme, 26,486 kilometers of rural roads were constructed and repaired, and a financial outlay of 6,448 crore. Sir, depriving women, vanchit ho rahe desh ki nari, khule ghum rahe shoshan kari. You have 240 MPs in parliament. If you had implemented the one-third quota as per the women's reservation bill, the BJP would have had 80 women MPs. But how many do they have? They have just 31, which is a mere 13% of their total strength. And compare this to the Trinamool Congress, sir, which boasts not 1%, 5%, 10%, 13%, 15%, 20%, 25%. Sir, it has 38% women MPs in Lok Sabha. Last year, a special session was convened to pass the Women's Reservation Bill. Yet the BJP failed to implement it in spirit. In West Bengal, we demonstrated that where there's a will, there is a way. We achieved substantial female representation without grandstanding in the media. That's the difference. Sir, this government is depriving the students. Tisri baar, Modi Sarkar kho gaya hai siksha ka adhikar. Sir, the inability to conduct NEET is one of the biggest failures of this government.
Shame, shame.
Jeopardizing the future of almost 33 lakh bright students. India parties, we all of us in the opposition, demanded a discussion on this in parliament, but hardly a word from the Honorable Prime Minister on this issue. Sir, our CM wrote to the PM for scraping NEET in favor of reverting to a system where state government conducts their own medical tests. Sir, more than 12,000 vacancies in Kendriya Vidyalayas nationwide are yet to be filled in. Sir, more than 7,50,000 vacancies for teaching posts nationwide from class 1 to class 8. More than 1,20,000 vacancies for teaching posts in UP alone from class 1 to class 8. Students account for 8% of total suicide victims. More than 13,000 students' lives are lost every year because of suicide, sir. Sir, depriving the working class, depriving the working class, mazdoor ki jeb ho rahi hai khali, batao kab ye halat hai sudharne wali. Sir, ILO data reveals that the growth rate of real wages between 2006 and 2013 was 6%. So the data suggests that the growth rate of real wages from 2006 to 2013 was at 6%. Between 2014 to 2021, it's down to 1.4%. The Indian Railways made a bold proclamation about upgrading 40,000 conventional coaches to Vande Bharat standards, turning a blind eye to the genuine struggle faced by everyday travelers, neglecting the fact that almost 96% of passengers journey in general and non-AC coaches. They continue to endure grave risks and vulnerabilities compounded by this government's sheer ineptitude. So now I come to G. G for guarantee. But a guarantee, but a, sir, khud bol raha hai, uska sarkar ka ghotala, sir, dekhiye. Sir, thank you. I would take that acronym. He's very good. Sir, G for guarantee, G for ghotala. Need ghotala and a guarantee with zero warranty. Sir, PM announced demonetization and guaranteed black money. Bhaiya, kitna self gold doge?
Hara diya tha to ek
kitna self gold doge? Dete raho. आपको ही डांट पड़ेगी. PM announced demonetization and guaranteed that black money would be wiped out. Sir, he failed. Sir, why I say guarantee with zero warranty? Why I say guarantee with zero warranty? Because PM announced demonetization. He said black money will be wiped out. Sir, this government failed. 99% of the black money came back into circulation and is in the system now. Sir, he guaranteed that terrorism would be curbed. Again failed. There has been 26 terror attacks in Jammu and Kashmir in the last 6 months. Sir, guaranteed to create 25 crore jobs in 2014. Failed. In 2023, the government admitted that in the last 10 years, only 1 crore jobs were created. Sir, guaranteed, everyone will have a house. The Prime Minister himself said that everyone, every Indian will have a roof over their head. Everyone will have a house by 2022. The Finance Minister proposed the construction of an additional 3 crore houses under PM Awas Yojana. Yet no mention has been made of 11,36,000 houses in Bengal that are still awaiting central funds. While the same money is being allocated to purchase aircraft worth 8,000 crore and construct palatial buildings as a part of Central Vista project worth 20,000 crores. And the poor people of this country still endure homelessness and remain without a roof over their heads. Still remains without a roof over their head. Another failed promise. So they guaranteed employment to the rural poor under MNREGA, but failed. As I said, not a penny has been allocated for Bengal in the last 3 financial years following BJP's embarrassing defeat in the 21 assembly elections. So they guaranteed to turn bullet trains into a reality by 2022. Failed again. Now the deadline has been conveniently shifted and postponed to 2026. Sir, 1 kilometer of bullet train costs 200 crore. 1 kilometer of dedicated freight corridor, DFCs on the other hand, costs 25 crore. Sir, railway accidents today has become the order of the day. But the union budget presented yesterday makes no mention of rail safety or installation of anti-collision devices or coverage in the passenger trains. Guaranteed to double farmers' income by 2022, it failed. Actual growth staggers at 3%. At this rate, farmers can expect their incomes to be doubled by 2035 or 2040. Over 1 lakh persons involved in farming sector tragically took their lives between 2014 and 2022. Around 30 suicides every single day. So they guaranteed that no home would be without electricity or water by 2022. So they failed again. They guaranteed to end terrorism. Failed again. More than 50 soldiers died in Jammu and Kashmir terrorist attack in the last 32 months. From 2018 to 2022, Jammu and Kashmir has seen 761 terrorist attacks and incidents leading to 174 civilian casualties. You make all the big promises, but you fail to keep them. You give all the guarantees, but those guarantees come with zero warranty. Sir, under this budget, one thing is clear. The only thing that is growing faster than price rise and inflation is BJP's list of broken promises and guarantees. So we have B for betrayal, U for unemployment, D for deprive, G for guarantee. Maine bola na sir, ye acronym ki sarkar hai, to main acronym mein hi jawab dunga. To budget ka B tha betrayal, U tha unemployment, D tha deprive, G tha guarantee. Ab main E pe aata hun. Sir, E for eccentric. Modi ji's eccentricity has turned this government, or rather the governance, into a circus, sir, costing the nation dearly. Sir, his obsession with grandstanding and distracting the countrymen from the real issues, leaving India to pay the price for his dictatorial displays. Sir, he announced unplanned lockdown. The government's abrupt announcement of the national lockdown in March 2020 left citizens with only 4 hours to prepare, triggering a widespread chaos and hardship. So the unplanned and poorly implemented lockdown resulted in tragic deaths, over 8,700 people, primarily migrant workers on our railway tracks and roads. So now I come to farm bills. In 2020, the same Modi government unilaterally passed 3 contentious farm bills without any consultation with the farmers or farmer organization or any opposition party.
Please, इसको रिकॉर्ड को क्लियर कर लो. इस सदन में 5.5 घंटे चर्चा हुई थी. इस सदन में किसान विधेयक. हाँ,
बिल पे कोई चर्चा नहीं हुआ है. बिल पे कोई चर्चा नहीं हुआ है.
किसान बिल पर
सर,
जब स्पीकर बोलता है तो बोलता है और वो सही बोलता है.
सर, बिल पे कोई चर्चा नहीं हुआ है. सर, भाई उनका ताली बजाना खत्म हो जाए तो
नहीं नहीं, पर माने
सर, आपने ये सदन का याद दिलाया ना.
एक मिनट माने सदस्य.
सर, आपने ये सदन
का याद दिलाया. माने सदस्य, जब मैं बोल रहा हूँ तो मैं कभी गलत नहीं बोल.
सर, आप मुझे एक चीज बता दीजिए. इस सदन में जो लोग ताली बजा रहे हैं, एक सेकंड सर, इस सदन में जो लोग ताली बजा रहे हैं, 700 फार्मर्स मारे गए, उनको मौत की घाट उतारा गया. सर, एक मिनट, एक आदमी ने मॉनिटर, एक आदमी ने एक एक मिनट के लिए खड़ा होके उनके ऊपर श्रद्धांजलि दिया, ये आज ताली बजा रहे, इसीलिए ऐसा हाल है इनका. और सर 700 लोग मारे गए ट्रेजिकली ओवर क्या 700 farmers died. व्हाट डिड यू डू? यू पीपल हैव ब्लड ऑन योर हैंड्स. इन 2020 sir, this contentious farm bill passed without any consultation with the opposition parties or farmers organization. Sir, this bills sparked massive protests as farmers. Sir, मैं एक बात स्पष्ट कर देता हूँ. एक चीज सर, ये जो बोल रहा है, मैं बोल रहा हूँ बीजेपी से. मैं जो सवाल यहाँ पे पूछ रहा हूँ इनसे, या मिनिस्टर को जो जवाब देना है, इनमें से कोई भी अगर जवाब देना चाहता है, कोई भी मीडिया चैनल चूज कर ले, मुझे टाइम बता दे, मैं आ जाऊंगा. एक हाथ लगे. मैं कह रहा हूँ सर, इनका दम है.
नो,
इनका सीने में दम है.
आप अपनी बात कहिए.
और अगर हिम्मत है
नो,
तो ये
आप चुनौती मत दीजिए. आप अपनी
आई एम गिविंग देम, आई एम चैलेंजिंग देम.
आप नो चुनौती मत दीजिए सदन में.
डिबेट विद मी.
नो चुनौती, ये बाहर चुनौती देना, या चुनौती सदन में नहीं.
सर, हार्श मेजर्स सच एज बार्ड वायर्स, सीमेंट बोल्डर्स एंड आयरन स्पाइक्स वेर डिप्लॉयड ऑन द रोड्स टू ब्लॉक फार्मर्स फ्रॉम एंटरिंग द कैपिटल. दिस रिवील्स द ट्रू फेस ऑफ दिस फेसिस गवर्नमेंट. सर, डिमोनिटाइजेशन. इन नवंबर 2016 द यूनियन गवर्नमेंट डिमोनिटाइज्ड 500 rupees एंड 1,000 rupees करेंसी नोट्स. Ostensibly, क्या
आप नो,
यू डोंट नो दैट डिमोनिटाइजेशन वाज डन इन 2016. सर, दिस गवर्नमेंट डिमोनिटाइज्ड 500 rupees एंड 1,000 rupees नोट. सर, ये मुझ पे आरोप लगा रहे, मैं पढ़ के बोल रहा हूँ. पीएम टेलीप्रॉम्प्टर से बोलते हैं. सर, प्राइम मिनिस्टर टेलीप्रॉम्प्टर से बोलते हैं. बेटा तो मैं पढ़ के ही बोलूंगा सर. अपना नेता को जाके क्या? अरे, अपना नेता को जाके क्या?
चर्चा मत करो, आप अपनी बात कहिए.
सर, डिमोनिटाइजेशन वॉज ब्रॉट टू कम्बैट ब्लैक मनी. It was brought to combat corruption. It was brought to combat terrorism.
However,
the move resulted in a severe cash crunch and significant economic destruction. Despite promises to eliminate black money, over 99% of the invalidated currency returned to the banking system, indicating the sheer failure of this initiative. सर शॉकिंगली काउंटरफीट नोट्स इंक्रीज बाई 10.7% इन 22 विथ फेक 500 रुपीज नोट राइजिंग टू 101.93% एंड 2000 रुपीज नोट बाई 54%. सैडली 130 फेलो इंडियंस लॉस्ट देयर लाइव्स ड्यू टू हीट एंड द स्ट्रेन ऑफ स्टैंडिंग इन लॉन्ग क्यूज फॉलोइंग विक्टिम टू दिस एक्सेंट्रिक डिसीजन. That's why we say E for eccentric. Now I come to the last letter. Sir, T.
माने सदस्य.
T for please. Tragedy.
माने सदस्य.
Sir, T for tragedy.
माने सदस्य आप वर्तमान बजट पे बोलें 2016 के बाद तो 2019 नहीं.
Sir मैं.
Sir जवाहरलाल नेहरू का बात और लोग बोलेगा. Sir.
Sir.
जवाहरलाल नेहरू का बात और लोग बोलेगा.
कोई 60 साल पहले जवाहरलाल नेहरू का बात करेगा दूसरे नेताओं का बात करेगा तब आप कुछ नहीं बोलेंगे.
सब बोलते
मैं 5 साल पहले का डिमोनिटाइजेशन का बात करूंगा तो आप कहेंगे भाई वर्तमान इशू पे बोलिए.
बजट
सर ये पक्षपात नहीं चलेगा सर.
बजट पे
मैं बजट पे ही बोल रहा हूँ. जब जब बिप्लब देव बोल रहा था तब 100 साल पुराना बात कर रहा था 50 साल पुराने इमरजेंसी का बात कर रहा था तब आप चुप थे और अब मैं डिमोनिटाइजेशन का बात कर रहा हूँ आपको चुप रहे. वाह वाह सर वाह.
बोलिए अपनी बात पे.
डी फॉर ट्रेजेडी एंड दिस इज द ट्रेजेडी द एग्जांपल यू ऑल सेट इन द हाउस दिस इज व्हाई आई से टी फॉर ट्रेजेडी. व्हेन द कोलकाता फ्लाईओवर कोलैप्स्ड फ्यू इयर्स अगो मोदी जी जेस्टेड दैट इट वाज नॉट एन एक्ट ऑफ गॉड. He said it's an act of fraud. Sir, we wonder what he has to say when 141 lives were lost in Morbi Bridge collapse in Gujarat. Was it an act of God or act of fraud? Yes. Sir, what happened when roofs of Delhi, Jabalpur and Gujarat airports collapsed? Was it an act of God or act of fraud? Yes. Sir, what happened when Ayodhya Ram Temple roof starts leaking after the first rain? Was it an act of God? Or an act of fraud? Sir, when Mumbai's Atal Setu started developing cracks within 6 months of its inauguration, was it an act of God or an act of fraud? When 41 workers trapped for 17 days after Uttarkashi tunnel was caved in, sir, was it an act of God or act of fraud? When 20 people killed as a girder launcher collapsed in Samruddhi Expressway in Thane, what was it? An act of God and an act of fraud? When 300 lives were lost in Balasore, train incident last year, what was it? Act of God or act of fraud? When 9 were killed and 40 people were injured as goods train rammed with Kanchenjunga Express last month, what was it, sir? An act of God or act of fraud? So the rail minister has blood on his hands. A once reliable mode of transport has been transformed into a death trap. Said 244 train accidents between 2017 and 2022. 15 major accidents in 2023 alone. Sir, 50% of compulsory track safety inspections were not even completed. Sir, only 672 crore spent out of the needed 58,459 crore on track renewal. Sir, Rashtriya Rail Sanraksha Koch, which would have received 20,000 crore every year, only received 4,225 crore. Sir, there's a shortfall and a staggering shortfall of 15,775 crore. Sir, Manipur is burning over the last almost 1.5 years. More than 200 killings, 70,000 displacements, 1,000 homes wrecked. Sir, no mention of the word Manipur in the union budget. Sir, another tragedy of this government is weaponization of central agencies. Sir, another tragedy of this government has been the weaponization of central agencies to carry out politically motivated witch hunts against opposition leaders, like many of us, including me. Sir, they didn't stop at me or my wife, my elderly parents, my PA, my advocate, even my 11-year-old daughter and 4-year-old son were not spared. Sir, you tried. Sir, the BJP tried to make an example out of me by setting an example for the rest of the country to see by letting ED and CBI go after me. Sir, but what did the people do? Desh mein janta malik hai, koi neta malik nahi hai. The people of Bengal and the people of my constituency elected me third time with a margin of 7,10,000 votes, setting an example for Narendra Modi, Amit Shah, and the minions of BJP and the rest of the country to see. This is the people's power. Sir, if I'll have to bow, I'll bow before the power of the people. I will not bow before the people in power. This people needs to understand. Sir, India's national debt today stands at a staggering 169 lakh crore. The finance minister needs to know this. Before you ridicule Bengal for a debt of 6 lakh crore, the budget has predominantly, like I said, is anti-Bengal and anti-people. Even though the state elected 12 BJP MPs as compared to 3 in Andhra Pradesh, you still have the guts and gall to overlook West Bengal, and you will get a befitting reply again. Perhaps the central government would have benefited drawing inspiration from West Bengal budget for the year 2024-2025. Sir, our budget stood out for its inclusive approach, introducing new schemes while enhancing the incentives of the existing ones. It comprehensively addressed the needs of every section of the society, ensuring support for women, youth, students, fishermen, and artisans alike. By prioritizing equitable growth and social welfare, it has set a commendable example of governance focused on holistic development of the people. So, sir, I have explained to this august house, including the finance minister, who is sadly not present in the house, BUDGET. I repeat again, B for betrayal, U for unemployment, D for deprive, G for ghotala and guarantee, and E for eccentric, and T for tragedy. Sir, the finance minister made a seventh budget. The finance minister made a seventh budget speech. Sir, more empty words, more empty promises, hollow words. This budget has got more fiction than finance. I have exposed the track record of this government, sir, on promises, on governance, on guarantees, and on targets. Since we are talking about the general budget and estimates and figures, we should also take a look at the audit, or try to take a look at an audit. Sir, if you audit the results of 2019 general elections, what will the audit show, sir? The election results are a direct audit of the performance of the Honorable Prime Minister and this government. The PM was the face, the body, and the head of the BJP campaign, which cried, Ab ki bar, char so par. And what is the result of that audit? The result of the audit is BJP lost heavily in Bengal. They were stunned in Uttar Pradesh, shaken up in Maharashtra. Their slogan was, Jo Ram ko laaye hai, hum unko laayenge backfired, sir. Okay. Their slogan of, Jo Ram ko laaye hai, hum unko laayenge backfired. I would rather say, Prabhu Ram aaye, to nyay aaya. Kuch waqt zarur laga, lekin insaaf aaya. BJP not only faced a humiliating defeat from the Ayodhya seat, but it also lost Badrinath in the last by-election. That takes me back from where I started. Waqt badal gaya hai. The Prime Minister now leads a creaky, vulnerable, shaky coalition. And it leads a coalition government which is just waiting to blow up. Rather than investing in the future of this country, it is unfortunate that the union government is investing for Modi ji's political survival at the expense of nation's well-being. Truth is, The Honorable Prime Minister is on borrowed time. You all are on borrowed time. Mark my words.
Yes.
And I would like to end by saying, थोड़ा सबर रखिए और कुर्सी का पीटी बांध लीजिए, मौसम बिगड़ने वाला है।